Marcella. The University of Chicago is in the race to find a vaccine. Research teams are working to develop disease-fighting technology.
Joining us now to talk about their research on a COVID-19 vaccine, Doctors Jeffrey Hubble and Melody Swartz, both professors of molecular engineering at the University of Chicago. Thank you both for joining us. Let's start with where we stand right now on this virus that you guys are working on, the vaccination, I should say, that you're working on.
Well, as you said, there's quite a race to develop a vaccine. Some vaccines are already in clinical trials now, initial clinical trials, the first candidates. Those may work well, we all hope. They may work less well than we hope, and they may work less well in some patient populations, such as the elderly. So for that reason, it's everybody's foot on the gas pedal to develop alternative technologies that may develop broad neutralizing responses against this virus.
Melody, how long? I'm sorry.
Yeah, this
I think there's a little back.
There is a lag.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Well, Melody, realistically, how long do you think it'll take to come up with a vaccine? Some are saying 4 years at the earlier. President Trump says soon.
Well, we and many others who are trying to develop vaccines, it all depends on regulatory issues because we, like, for example, from start till now, it's been 4 weeks and we already have our vaccines in mice. And so, you know, we can very quickly get to the point where we would be ready for clinical trials, but it's the clinical trials that take so long and the regulatory issues there.
Is it possible we never catch up with this, we never figure it out, and we end up having to live with it like we do with the flu? Or is this different because it's a coronavirus?
I think it's unlikely that we never develop a vaccine. You know, we've been trying on HIV vaccines for a long time and have not succeeded there. With this virus, since many people are responding well already, even without therapy, it's likely the body is able to develop adequate responses to it. So it seems likely that we will be successful in developing a vaccine. So with the flu, we're successful somewhat. The flu vaccine makes a big difference. As I mentioned, in elderly patients, for example, it makes less of a difference. So that's why some of us are working on technologies to try to develop broad responses.
Aside from a vaccine, is there any type of medication that can be taken to kind of ease the symptoms? Some people are saying hydroxychloroquine is the answer. What are your thoughts?
Well, there are extensive efforts to develop drugs to modulate the pathology. So, for example, lung pathology occurs in COVID-19. So there are clinical trials on drugs to block the exuberant inflammation that occurs in the lung and causes a pneumonia-like phenomenon. That's one of them. Antivirals, the remdesivir from Gilead, is in clinical trials. That may have an effect. So one hopes that we do have both antivirals, like remdesivir, as well as compounds to modulate the exuberant inflammation that occurs.
But so far, from the news reports that I've read, the hydroxychloroquine trials have not shown any specific benefit.
So in addition to the coronavirus vaccine work you're doing, there's also a bigger project to just sort of research other diseases. And as I understand it, this is the culmination of a couple of years of work. You have a lot of experts and teams assembled, it sounds like, which is providing a lot of promise across a lot of areas.
We do. At the University of Chicago, in our Immunoengineering Innovation Center, we have efforts in autoimmunity with tolerance-inducing technologies. We have efforts in immuno-oncology to induce immune responses and vaccine responses in cancer, and these in infectious disease. So there are a number of efforts we have underway.
And furthermore, in terms of vaccine technology, our technology is really a baseline platform that can be applied for other vaccines as well. And so we have tested that in malaria, in tuberculosis, in HIV, and in Lassa virus. So there's a lot that we're doing towards engineering immune responses.
And one quick question, how many researchers are working on a vaccine right now, would you say?
In our laboratory, there are about 20 researchers that are focused on this problem, and they're just amazing how fast they're moving. Like I said, in COVID-19, we've gone from launch to first mice being treated in a period of 4 weeks, which is rocket fast. It's a little bit complex to keep the team socially distanced in the laboratory, so people come in all hours, early in the morning, late at night, so as to maintain distancing in the lab to keep a safe environment. But the team of immunologists, chemists, and engineers in the lab is really working hard on this.
Fantastic.
And we should say you guys are married. That's why you're so close.
Yeah.
We're not socially distanced.
That's right.
Thank you so much.
Wow. You're doing incredible work. We appreciate it, and we wish you the best.
Thank you.
Thank you.
To be with you.
Be safe. Be well.
Thank you.